Gimana bros?
With the balm of your healing love. Amen.
The path of many leaders, for many leaders is to be exalted in life and forgotten.
The path for many leaders is to be exalted in life and forgotten after death. The pattern for all who serve God, famous or obscure, respected or ignored, is that death is the door to glory. Her late Majesty famously declared on a 21st birthday broadcast that her whole life would be dedicated to serving the nation and Commonwealth. Rarely has such a promise been so well kept. Few leaders receive the outpouring of love that we have seen. Jesus, who in our reading does not tell his disciples how to follow, but who to follow, said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." Her late Majesty's example was not set through her position or her ambition, but through whom she followed. I know His Majesty shares the same faith and hope in Jesus Christ as his mother, the same sense of service and duty. In 1953, the Queen began her coronation with silent prayer, just there, at the high altar. Her allegiance to God was given before any person gave allegiance to her. Her service to so many people in this nation, the Commonwealth and the world, had its foundation in her following Christ, God himself, who said that he came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many. People of loving service are rare in any walk of life. Leaders of loving service are still rarer. But in all cases, those who serve will be loved and remembered when those who cling to power and privileges are long forgotten. The grief of this day, felt not only by the late Queen's family, but all round the nation, the Commonwealth and the world, arises from her abundant life and loving service, now gone from us. She was joyful, present to so many, touching a multitude of lives. And we pray today especially for all her family, grieving as every family at a funeral, including so many families round the world who have themselves lost someone recently. But in this family's case, doing so in the brightest spotlight. May God heal their sorrow. May the gap left in their lives be marked with memories of joy and life. Her late Majesty's broadcast during COVID lockdown ended with, "We will meet again." Words of hope from a song of Vera Lynn. Christian hope means certain expectation of something not yet seen. Christ rose from the dead and offers life to all, abundant life now and life with God in eternity. As the Christmas carol says, where meek souls will receive him, still the dear Christ enters in. We will all face the merciful judgment of God. We can all share the Queen's hope, which in life and death inspired her servant leadership. Service in life, hope in death. All who follow the Queen's example and inspiration of trust and faith in God can with her say, we will meet again.
These are the presidents that came to her funeral. France, United States, Poland, European Union, Spain, Sweden.
Thank you. In confidence and trust, let us pray to the Father.
Let us give thanks to God for Queen Elizabeth's long life and reign, recalling with gratitude her gifts of wisdom, diligence, and service. O God, from whom cometh everything that is upright and true, accept our thanks for the gifts of heart and mind that thou didst bestow upon thy daughter Elizabeth, and which she showed forth among us in her words and deeds. And grant that we may have grace to live our lives in accordance with thy will, to seek the good of others, and to remain faithful servants unto our lives' end. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Confident in God's love and compassion, let us pray for all those whose hearts are heavy with grief and sorrow. Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously, we pray thee, with those who mourn, that casting every care on thee, they may know the consolation of thy love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray for His Majesty the King and all the royal family, that they may know the sustaining power of God's love and the prayerful fellowship of God's people. Almighty God, the fountain of all goodness, we humbly beseech thee to bless our most gracious Sovereign Lord, King Charles, Camilla, the Queen Consort, William, Prince of Wales, and all the royal family. Endure them with thy Holy Spirit, enrich them with thy heavenly grace, prosper them with all happiness, and bring them to thine everlasting kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
In recognition of Queen Elizabeth's service to this United Kingdom, let us rejoice in her unstinting devotion to duty, her compassion for her subjects, and her counsel to her ministers. And we pray for the continued health and prosperity of this nation. Almighty God, whose will it is that all thy children should serve thee in serving one another, look with love, we pray thee, on this nation. Grant to its citizens grace to work together with honest and faithful hearts, each caring for the good of all, that seeking first thy kingdom and its righteousness, they may possess all things needful for their daily sustenance and the common good. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us give thanks for Queen Elizabeth's commitment to the Commonwealth throughout her reign, for her service and dedication to its people, and for the rich bonds of unity and mutual support she sustained. O Almighty and Everlasting God, hear our prayer for the Commonwealth, and grant it the guidance of thy wisdom. Inspire those in authority that they may promote justice and the common good. Give to all its citizens the spirit of mutual honour and respect, and grant to us all grace to strive for the establishment of righteousness and peace, for the honour of thy name. Amen.
We give thanks to God for Queen Elizabeth's loyalty to the faith she inherited through her baptism and confirmation and affirmed at her coronation, for her unswerving devotion to the gospel, and for her steadfast service as Supreme Governor of the Church of England. Lord, we beseech thee to keep thy household, the Church, in continual godliness, that through thy protection she may be free from all adversities and devoutly given to serve thee in all good works, to the glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us pray that we may be given grace to live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. Bring us, O Lord God, at our last awakening, into the house and gate of heaven, to enter into that gate and dwell in that house, where there shall be no darkness, nor dazzling, but one equal light, no noise, nor silence, but one equal music, no fears, nor hopes, but one equal possession, no ends, nor beginnings, but one equal eternity, in the habitation of thy glory and dominion, world without end. In confidence and hope, let us pray to the Father in the words our Saviour taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
let us commend to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer, the soul of Elizabeth, our late Queen. Heavenly Father, King of Kings, Lord and Giver of Life, who of thy grace in creation didst form mankind in thine own image, and in thy great love offerest us life eternal in Christ Jesus, claiming the promises of thy most blessed Son, we entrust the soul of Elizabeth, our sister here departed, to thy merciful keeping, in sure and so certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, when Christ shall be all in all, who died and rose again to save us, and now liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit in glory forever. Amen. Go forth, O Christian soul, from this world. In the name of God the Father Almighty, who created thee, in the name of Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who suffered for thee, in the name of the Holy Spirit, who was poured out upon thee and anointed thee, in communion with all the blessed saints, and aided by the angels and archangels and all the armies of the heavenly host, may thy portion this day be in peace, and thy dwelling in the heavenly Jerusalem. Amen.
Thank you. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the King, the Commonwealth, and all people, peace and concord, and to us sinners, life everlasting. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
service ended, Her Majesty's coffin is borne towards the final departure from Westminster Abbey, towards Windsor Castle, at her final resting place in St. George's Chapel. This moment recalls the words of a writer commemorated at Poets' Corner here in the Abbey, the former Poet Laureate, Sir William Wordsworth. Yet shall some tribute of regret be paid when her long life hath reached its final day? Men are we and must grieve when even the shade of that which once was great is passed away.
Out into the sunshine outside Westminster Abbey, the bearer party doing its work, taking the Queen's coffin over to the state gun carriage of the Royal Navy, ready for that procession through central London. That magnificent wreath, which bears a simply worded card from the King saying, "In loving and devoted memory, Charles R." The Imperial State Crown, the orb and scepter, the emblems of majesty and earthly power, glinting and gleaming in the sunlight. The end of this state funeral service, the first to be held at the Abbey since 1760. So truly a day of history and a funeral service for the longest reigning monarch in British history. the wreath itself, according to the king's wishes, containing flowers and foliage cut from the gardens of Buckingham Palace, Clarence House, and Highgrove House. Two naval ratings, once again in place, looking immaculate, ready to draw this century-old gun carriage through the streets of central London. Stokes, the great funeral procession sets off from Westminster Abbey. The mournful beat of the music. And the Queen's final progress through the heart of London, the city of her birth, gets underway. Seen in Britain for 70 years, since the funeral procession for King George VI in 1952. More than 3,000 military personnel taking part, along with representatives of civilian organisations. Which is along the bow, we have representatives of Commonwealth countries and the armed forces, led by the Mounties, the Canadian Mounted Police. the Mounties leading the way, along to Wellington Arch, flanked by Mounted Metropolitan Police, followed by contingent of those who've been recipients of the George Cross and Victoria Cross, and representatives of the Armed Forces of Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and other Commonwealth countries. Passing the gates of New Palace Yard and the Palace of Westminster and the Houses of Parliament, where of course Her Majesty attended on so many occasions for the state opening of Parliament. And all of this happening under the steady gaze of Sir Winston Churchill, dominating this part of Parliament Square. Queen's first Prime Minister, the young Queen, who expressed her debt of gratitude to the older man for the guidance that he gave in those first few years of the reign. Which includes foliage chosen for its symbolism. The kings had a very big hand in this. Rosemary for remembrance. Myrtle, the ancient symbol of a happy marriage. And it was cut from a plant that was grown from a sprig of myrtle in the wedding bouquet of Princess Elizabeth to Prince Philip back in 1947. And English oak, which symbolizes the strength of love. Thank you. leapt her joy when she mingled with the crowds on VE Day in 1945, and where throughout her years as sovereign, she led the nation in November on Remembrance Sunday, placing her wreath at the cenotaph and pausing to remember those lost in conflicts in the service of their country. Benevolent Fund, the Soldiers, Sailors and Air Force Association. Procession now away down the Mall towards Buckingham Palace. The procession itself is a mile and a quarter long. Reversed as a sign of mourning. Thank you. Princess of Wales, George and Charlotte. In one of the cars following this procession, majestic sight. The sun has come out, making the colours so vibrant. On the Mall, looking up to Admiralty Arch, the scene, of course, every year of the happy event of the birthday parade, the Queen's parade and the official birthday. Today, it's an opportunity to escort Her Majesty one last time along the Mall and past the London home of Buckingham Palace. His Majesty the King leading the party of close family members. Gently turning towards the entrance of the Horse Guards and the narrow archway which will lead onto the parade ground. The Royal Company of Archers, one of the groups of Royal Bodyguards. Officially classed as the main entrance to the estate, including St. James's Palace and Buckingham Palace. Thank you. and on to the familiar expanse of Horse Guards Parade, where for decades Her Majesty has attended the birthday parade in early June to mark her official birthday. For many, many years, of course, she would come on horseback. In later times, in a carriage, but devoted to the event itself and thoroughly enjoyed the music with an expert eye for detail. And she knew the parade, tribute of colour, better than anyone. Scepter, the monarch's symbol of fairness and justice. And circling around the great Queen Victoria Memorial. The Royal Air Force there played such an important part, of course, in the events of the 8th of September and later, bringing the Queen back to London from Scotland. The Queen's body was accompanied by the Princess Royal. The Royal Air Force flew actually back to RAF Northolt. Touched by, and is one of the drum horses. Drums draped in black. This one is called Apollo, one of the latest additions to the Royal Mews, and the state trumpeter. Division, the Household Cavalry, the Blues and Royals, and we talked about the helpful uniforms. They are the Percivants and the Heralds and the Kings of Arms there in. The scene at Buckingham Palace is this procession stretches now from Constitution Hill all the way back to Horse Guards. The representatives of the Army and the Royal Air Force and the Navy, the band of the Irish Guards and the Welsh Guards, this section of the parade. Some of the elements of the procession to Prince George and Princess Charlotte and the Princess of Wales. Looking on. And then we have the Duchess of Sussex and the Countess of Wessex. Thank you. Lord Timothy Lawrence, Duke of York, Gloucester, Peter Phillips. VI, who died a relatively young man in his 50s, back in 1952, of course, being that the Queen came to the throne at the age of 25. And no question that King George VI was responsible for shaping this remarkable reign that we've seen over the past 70 years towards this of central London, which is near the gardens of Buckingham Palace, and what is normally a very busy section of Hyde Park Corner. Today it's solemn and silent with this funeral procession for the late Queen. And this is the scene at Wellington Arch, which stands right in the middle of Hyde Park Corner, the ancient home of the Duke of Wellington nearby, and Wellington Arch named because of that connection. At one stage, the arch was planned as the main entrance to Buckingham Palace, but as with Marble Arch, things were changed at a later date. And this is where we will have a gathering of thousands of members of the armed forces for this final part of the ceremony in London, where the Queen's coffin will be transferred from that gun carriage to the state hearse, which will be waiting to take the Queen home to Windsor. So many occasions where she stood with her father and mother, King and Queen, at the end of the Second World War, of Windsor and other royal residences, but Buckingham Palace was always the office, and here we have the staff of the palace. Celebration of those times. Of course, shared by the royal family and all of the royal household in today's procession, and millions watching wherever they're watching around the world. We remember those occasions with equal joy. Thank you. Great Hyde Park on Piccadilly. And not too far away, they're from her birthplace in Mayfair. Life at sea, and of course from the Queen's point of view, a tribute to her late father before the committal takes place. Thank you. Moments that few of us will ever forget, I'm sure. National anthem played as Her Late Majesty was taken from Wellington Arch and is now on the way to Windsor. After a very moving service at the Abbey and some clearly expressed messages, including those of the Archbishop of Canterbury, about the Queen's life of service and dedication, a sense of duty, and then the magnificent, solemn, moving procession all the way from the Abbey to Wellington Arch. And there are crowds on the streets here approaching Knightsbridge, lots of them offering floral tributes, others just maintaining a dignified silence. Come to see their Queen for the last time as she leaves London. Katie Nicholl and Robert Hardman are still with me here in the studio looking at these scenes, and they've been watching the procession and the service before that. Katie, as we see the Queen's final departure from the capital, I suspect that these are the images that will stay with people for many years to come.
I don't think anyone that watched that, he will ever forget it. And you said during your commentary, so many memories. And that's what struck me as I watched that procession pass those landmarks that have punctuated the Queen's life and punctuated ours, because we look forward to Trooping the Colour and those birthday parades. You know, I look at my life and it's been marked by the silver, the diamond, the gold, all these wonderful jubilees. And I can't help but think back to the Platinum Jubilee celebrations and the last time that the Queen stepped out on that balcony. And I think if anyone's wondering, what must she make of all of this? Remember when she stepped out for the last time, overwhelmed with emotion, that sea of faces, that sea of people there for her. Well, today they turned out again to bid a final farewell.
They did, Robert, and the sense of love and respect and admiration is just as strong as the sense of loss.
It is, Hugh. I thought it was rather touching. We saw just a few moments